Hi guys, Big Bang Maker here. So it's been a long time that I have ridden a 150cc or a 200cc bike, because recently it has all been super bikes or 600cc bikes only. I was really excited to see how this 150cc bike will be, because there was a lot of hype about how this bike will perform. For now, the seating position is, you feel like you're sitting on a sofa or something, and your legs are all the way in the front, as you see here. So basically you're leaning back like an inclining chair and keeping your foot up here. From the side it certainly looks bulky, but when you're sitting on the saddle it looks absolutely awesome. The bike is absolutely smooth, and as you see here, I'm gripping the tank with my knees over here. But the thing is, there is no vibration or anything. That is because it's Suzuki bike, dude, come on. The engine is similar to that of Gixxer or Gixxer SF, and it is tuned in a different manner. 15 bhp, 14 newton meters of torque. The bike feels really light. The gearbox is really, really smooth. And what shocked me to the core was that this bike has ABS in it. So this one has single channel ABS, meaning ABS is available as an option only in the front. No, it's not switchable. There are few weird things here, because the key goes over here, and as you see, the ABS option being over here. The thing is, yes, you'll have to put the key over here, and not, they could have given it somewhere here and made it a little more classier, but I don't know why they have done it there. Maybe you can put a windshield. No, I guess you'll have to drill holes through this if you want to have a windshield. And as I've said in many videos, I'm 6 foot tall, but I'm not finding the, you know, the foot peg position to be weird or anything. I'm comfortably sitting. So the mirror can be easily adjusted to your liking, and the handlebars a little close to you, but your hands are literally parallel and very free. Yes, liter tank here, though.
11 liters, sir.
11 liters tank. Okay. So basically on a bike like this, the mileage will be really good, maybe around 40, even 45. So on 11 liters, you can easily do 400, 450 kilometers easily. The handlebar is really light. The clutch is soft. The front suspension is a little soft. It's not really bumpy or anything. As soon as you brake, as you see here, it dives down a little, but it's not scary as such. The ground clearance is really good, as you see over there. I really am feeling like I'm riding a Gixxer SF or a Gixxer. Only thing is that the seating position and the riding position is a little different. Apart from that, you have that bulletproof guarantee or reliability from the Suzuki engine. No issues there at all. I really like the placement of this instrument cluster over here. Even if it's really sunny out here, I'm able to read everything. The gear shift indicator, the speed that I'm doing, RPM, everything is really good. And as you see here, the handlebar is properly straight and it's towards you. And initially when you sit on the bike, you feel a little weird, but then now that I've been riding for the last 5 to 6 minutes, I've really adjusted to the bike easily. I'll have to check the turning radius, because you see how much the bike is turning here. But for now, when you're taking a left or right, the bike doesn't feel heavy or anything. I have a pillion here as well, and no complaints whatsoever. Well, it's a really good family bike is what I want to say. Certainly looks like a bigger Intruder, and certainly is inspired by that. The bike sounds very, very sweet. As you saw over there, going through traffic is no big deal. I'm absolutely in love with the brakes of the bike. Very good confidence when you're braking. The rear brake is soft and works really good. I'm in fourth gear right now and you see that it's pulling. You know, I haven't changed the gear or anything. There is ample torque in the low end. And it easily goes, as you see here, the bike easily pulls. There is no stress whatsoever that I'm seeing. So I'll try to take a U-turn over here and show you how the bike really feels. Let's see how the U-turn is. Wow, this is really good. This is really, really good. The turning radius is really small and as you saw over there, it's really maneuverable. No issues at all. Even the pillion is comfortable. Sir, seat hegide nimdo?
Comfortable, sir.
Comfortable, no? Nice. Even the rider seat is plush. The seat foam is soft and it's, as I said, you really feel like you're on a sofa. The switchgear quality is also very good. And I'm really happy by the fact that, you know, at entry level, which is at around 150cc, Suzuki is making sure to provide ABS and encouraging every other manufacturer brand in India to go for an ABS even at 150cc level. So huge thumbs up for that. Initially, I really thought that, you know, this riding position would be really uncomfortable for me, but it's really not. It's very comfortable. If you're a short rider, you will find it even more comfortable, even more at home. Since I've ridden Avenger recently on a long ride, which I'd taken it for Kerala, to be honest, the handlebar was a little close and I got a little back pain, as I said. But in this, I don't see that at all. As you see here, my arms are really free. The handlebar is, even though it is short, it is still far away from my body. So it's very easily grippable as well. The indicators and everything are right here. You can really see what's really happening on the road. Because of the headlight being that far ahead, you feel like there is too much of bike. But when you're riding it around in the city, you don't really feel so. It feels like a small bike which you can take it around. You can certainly use this for touring. That is what it's given for. Suzuki, wow man, you have done a fantastic job. Very good. The paint finish and the quality of this fiber is also very, very good. So the on-road price of this motorcycle is around 1,20,000 rupees. It might vary from state to state, region to region. But if you come to Advait Suzuki, you will definitely see that the on-road price is 1,20,000. Honestly, when you go over humps and all, you don't really feel it. The rear suspension is medium soft and it's tuned very, very nicely. I'm doing 55 kilometers per hour, going over the hump, absolutely no issues. It takes the potholes and bumps very nicely, so there is no strain on your body at all. You're sitting absolutely straight. When you see it from far, you won't really realize the capacity or the quality that the bike has. Only when you ride it, you really understand how this bike is. Very good. Okay, so this is Chandru. Thank you, sir. And as you see here, the bike looks bulky, but it doesn't really feel so. Obviously, you see the ABS sticker over here. This is what shocked me when I went into the showroom. The performance, as you saw in the city, was really good. If you take it on the highway, that is when you get to know more about the bike. The stance is really good from the front. This angle is what I really like. And as you see the seat over here, it was really cushioning me and I was keeping my back here very nicely. It is soft. And the LED tail lamp from behind is also looking absolutely brilliant. So this is my first ride impression as to how the Intruder 150 really was. Suzuki has done their magic with this. Certainly can be a fantastic competitor for Avenger. And you can consider this. Do take a test ride and find out. Thank you.